Shear stress and skin friction in pipes. Basically, in this topic, we are assuming that a fluid is flowing in a particular pipe, and what is the behavior, or I can say, what is the change in shear stress and skin friction in that pipe. We all know about shear stress, but what is this skin friction? Basically, skin friction is a friction which exists between a fluid and surface of the pipe. So, if this is a pipeline and the fluid flowing inside a pipe, the friction which is exists at the surface of the pipe between that surface and liquid, or I can say fluid. So, if I want to define a skin friction, then the skin friction is a friction which is exists between a fluid and a surface of a pipe. That is known as skin friction. So now if I want to relate shear stress and skin friction when a fluid flowing in a pipe, for that I have taken here one example or one system to derive a relation between shear stress and skin friction. You can see in the figure, this is a pipe in which the fluid is flowing. You can see here, this is the direction of the flow. Here the fluid is flowing, this is the main pipeline. Here I have assumed a small disc shape of the fluid. So consider the steady flow of a fluid through a horizontal tube or pipe. Here we have imagined a disc shaped element of fluid. The radius of that element is R, and the length of that element is dl. Here I have mentioned already that this is the dl, this is the radius of the disc shaped element, which is r. Fine. So here we have imagined a disc shaped element of fluid of radius r and length dl. And that disc shaped element is concentric with the axis of the tube. Fine. This is concentric with the axis of the tube. Here, we have imagined this disc shaped element. The pressure which is exists at this upstream phase of the disc is P, and the pressure at the downstream phase of the disc is taken as P plus dP. So let P and P plus dP be the fluid pressure on upstream and downstream phases of the disc respectively. But here, to derive a relation between shear stress and skin friction in pipe, we have taken some assumptions. Now, what are the assumptions? We have here assumed that the flow is fully developed flow and the density of the fluid to be constant. We have taken these two assumptions while we are deriving the equation, that the flow is fully developed flow and the density of the fluid is constant. So, this is the description of our system which we have taken and the assumptions. So, now let us derive the equation. And one more thing, the shear stress which is acting here, see here. Shear stress which is acting at the two phases of the disc shape, the element is tau. Fine, we have generally taken the shear stress notation as tau. So, clear the notation which we have taken for the system. Disc shaped element radius is R. Whole tube radius is RW. Shear stress which is acting on the disc shaped element surface is tau. Shear stress which is acting at this tube surface is tau W. Length of the tube disc shaped element is DL. Radius of the disc shaped element is R. And the pressures which is acting on the fluid disc shaped element at the upstream phase is P, and at the downstream phase is P plus dP. So now let's start to derive the equation. Here the sum of all the forces which is acting on the disc shaped element is zero. Why? Because we have assumed that the flow is fully developed flow. We have already studied the definition of fully developed flow in our chapter basic equation of fluid. Fine. So when we are assuming the fully developed flow, sum of all the forces which is acting on that disc-shaped element is zero. So first of all, what we have to do, we have to list up all the forces which is acting on the disc-shaped element. And then we have to take the summation of all the forces equals to zero. So let us first list out all the forces which is acting on disc-shaped element. The pressure force on upstream face of the disc. Upstream face of the disc, that means in the direction of flow. So pressure is what? Pressure is force into area. The force which is acting is P and area is pi r square. So the pressure force on upstream face of the disc is P pi r square. And generally the force which is acting in direction of flow, we will take it as positive sign, and the force which is acting in opposite to the direction of flow, we will take it as negative. So this is the upstream force which is acting in the direction of flow, so we will take it as positive. So pressure force on upstream face of the disc is P pi r square in the direction of flow, which is positive. Now next is pressure force on downstream face of the disc. Fine. So pressure in the downstream phase, which is P plus dP into area, so we will get the force value. So P plus dP into pi r square. So finally, the pressure force on downstream phase of the disc is P plus dP into pi r square, which is in the opposite direction of the flow. So we will take it as negative. Next is the shear force, which is acting at the outer surface of the disc. I have already explained you right now. So the shear force acting at the outer surface of the disc due to viscosity of fluid. For pressure force, what we have to do? Pressure into area. Same way, for shear force, we have to do shear stress into area. So shear force acting at the outer surface of the disc due to viscosity of the fluid is shear stress into cylindrical area. Fine. So what is shear stress? Tau. And what is cylindrical area? 2 pi r dl. We all know the area of cylinder. So finally, my shear force is tau 2 pi r dl. Again, it is acting in the opposite to flow. So we will take it as negative. Fine. So now we have all the equation of forces. And for fully developed flow, summation of all the forces is equal to 0. So summation F is equal to 0. So take summation of all the equation we have listed out. See, P pi r square minus P plus dP pi r square minus tau 2 pi r dl is equal to 0. Simplifying the equation, open that bracket of P plus dP. So P pi r square plus P pi r square minus. So that both terms will be cancelled out. And the equation becomes pi r square dP plus tau 2 pi r dl equals to 0. We are just simplifying the equation, nothing else. So the now equation becomes pi r square dP plus tau 2 pi r dl equals to 0. Now for further simplification, we are dividing the equation by pi r square dl. So when you divide this equation by pi r square dl, you will get dp by dl plus 2 tau by r equals to 0. This is my equation number 1. Got the point? We are just dividing the equation by pi r square dl for simplification purpose. So dp by dl plus 2 tau by r is equals to 0. This is my equation number 1. Now in steady state laminar or turbulent flow, either type of the flow, in steady state, the pressure at any given cross section of stream tube is constant. Fine. For any type of the flow in steady state, pressure at any given cross section is constant. Therefore, dP by dl is independent of R. As the pressure at any point is constant, so dP by dl is independent of R. So, for entire cross section, I have already told you tau and R is what? Shear stress and radius of disc shape element. But now if I want to mention for the whole tube, then what will happen? Tau will be replaced by tau W, that means tau is equal to tau W and R is equal to RW. What is RW? Radius of the tube, and tau W is the shear stress at the wall of the tube. So, in steady state laminar or turbulent flow, the pressure at any given cross section is constant. Therefore, dP by dl is independent of R. So, for entire cross section of the tube, R is equal to RW and tau is equal to tau W. So, the equation number 1 can be written as dP by dl plus 2 tau W by RW is equal to 0. This is my equation number 2. Now, subtracting equation 1 from equation 2. We have the two equation 1 and 2. Now, what we are going to do? Subtracting equation number 1 from equation number 2. We will get tau W by RW is equal to tau by R. Simply, we are subtracting the two equations. You will get the equation as tau W by RW equals to tau by R. So, I can say that the simple linear relation between tau and R throughout the tube cross section, when I want to show in the form of graph, it look like as this. Fine. So, tau W by W is equal to tau by R, and when we want to show the graphical relation, then it look like this. You can easily understand from the nature of the graph. Fine. Shear stress from the center of the pipe to the pipe wall where the radius is RW. So, this is the relation between shear stress and skin friction. Fine. So, this is the derivation of flow of incompressible fluid through conduits and thin layer, which shows the relation between shear stress and skin friction in a pipe or tube. So, this is all for today's session. I hope this is clear to all. Thank you.